Always surprise, surprise, it's not often you get a week. Apple's upcoming iPhone design paints that day. In collaboration with Max Windback, I'll be sharing with you the iPhone 12 Pro Max, the 6.7-inch flagship design. It's exactly what we expected it to be. There are many little key differences between the 11 Pro Max and this device I did not perceive, so let's get into those details. There's so much here I want to say. After Escula sprinting this, spend some time with it comparing it to the 11 Pro Max series. It's a week. This is in every way of evolution for the iPhone design, and after handling it feels amazing to me. This device just fuels futuristic thanks to a huge reduction in bezels, massive camera and a smaller notch. There are so many little things on the design I did not foresee Apple doing, and I'd like to cover all of those in this video. I had so many weeks to share, but I had to split this video up into this week, and we'll be doing another exclusive on the features and more in depth on the camera and displays, including ProMotion or 120Hz refresh rate leaks. So stay tuned. i3 printed Esculus printed it to get the detail out, and comparing it to the 11 Pro Max, I was pleasantly surprised with just how futuristic it feels. In no way was the square housing uncomfortable or digging into your palm like I thought it would be. This is pretty much the design of the iPad Pro, and the iPhone just reported that the iPhone would be very iPad Pro like. I can confirm without a shadow of a doubt that that is true. So where did this cat originate from? Apple would love to know, but Max Windback's source works with accessories, and it's pretty standard issue to receive this cat around this time. Unclear how from where, but this is legitimate. John Prosser also chimed in saying, yes, this is the real deal. Max Windback does one is that it's 70% complete. This gives us an idea of how the body, the frame, will look. The general camera size and positioning in the notch here is not 100%, so the cat itself came with the same existing size notch, but some recent leaks from Max Windback source gave us information to fill in there, and all kind of talk about why the shape is the way that it is. Far from confirmed, there was a report back in January by Mac at the Car at which detailed the iPhone 12 Pro Max and give us some specifications. The size of the lens was growing, the body was 7.4 mm. This cat confirms that. In fact, it's more than likely that they had these cats back in January and we just now got access to the. So yes, it is 7.4 mm. It's thinner than 11 Pro Max. You certainly feel it is just a little bit of a larger device, slightly taller and slightly wider, 7.8 mm versus 7.7 of the 11 Pro Max. The display to body ratio is higher. Now the bezels are 9 mm thinner, meaning it has a much more futuristic look. Entire phone is larger now to 6.7 inches display, so it definitely feels massive and there's a huge presence to it. The source also confirmed the camera layout on the rear, that iOS 14 glyph that we saw earlier. It's true, they confirmed that is the actual layout of the sizing and spacing of the lenses is not completely correct, but the overall lens is different. It's about 5 mm larger in length and width, and it's now a perfect square compared to the 11 Pro Max, which is a slightly elongated rectangle. The bottom right module is a LiDAR sensor, although Apple is testing out a version where the LiDAR sensor sits on the top right alongside that model. There was a separate model. Apple is still not done finalizing the design, so we could see some shift here, but Apple is looking into two separate prototypes. The other model had a notch that wasn't as tall but was as wide as current notches on the iPhone, and this notch that you're looking at in our design, so the curvature of the notch has actually changed in the prototype. The notch was the same with the curvature was different. Then the source obtained information that the notch would be shrinking, would be just a little larger than the OnePlus 6 notch, so as a point of reference that's how large it could be, slightly larger, and we've adjusted the CAD to feature that notch. So the notch not confirmed, we know roughly how large it could be, not be curvature. This curvature was on the original cabin notch, so used in the smaller version. Else too early to say whether or not the entire lineup will have a flat edged chassis, although in Bloomberg's report they mentioned that at least two models will. The 12 Pro series, we don't know about the 12 non-pro yet. Now the glass is completely flat, gone is 2.5. the glass with the edges wrapped traps into the rounded frame. This glass is almost completely flat with a very subtle curve on the edges. When you get in real close, the glass itself sits slightly above the frame, 0.8 mm, very similar to that of the iPad Pro right now, but generally it seems like a safer design, where if you drop it not as much glass is exposed, as on current models now in the frame. The antenna bands are now getting wider, they're now 1.83 millimeters compared to 1 millimeter on the 11 Pro series. Of course, because of 5G, we knew that Apple is working extensively on new antenna technology, and the new models will have higher cellular and Wi-Fi speeds. This is a natural result of that Apple is widening the antenna bands. Another interesting detail about the camera is the run-up is changing, the way it juts out of the glass on the back is changing, so the lenses on the current 11 Pro protrude much more than they will on the iPhone 12 Pro series. Those will be almost the new iPad Pro like, where the lens itself sits closer to the glass. They don't jut out as much, but the overall lens run-up will jut out more. Here is a very crude graphic to show you that. So as you can see, the 11 Pro Max run-up slightly less, not as tall, but the 12 Pro one is taller, but the lenses themselves do not protrude as much. This coupled with the larger lens means that camera has quite a presence on the back, and it's a very even looking design. I honestly like it, but we got one thing wrong in our concept, so disregard this. The lidar sensor will likely have an aesthetic ring like the other lenses. We don't portray that in our renders right now, and our next exclusive renders will show that it'll likely be slightly raised for more even look on the lens, and it's possible we made the lenses slightly too large in our concept. We don't know how much larger they're getting, but likely about 1 to 2 millimeters larger. Will work on the spacing again. This CAD was only 70% complete, the rest were filling in with the source's information. Now I assume the smaller 6.1 inches Pro model will have the same large camera, but until we see that in the cans, we cannot confirm it. Also, the mute switch likely not going to be a vertical mute switch as Ben Gaskin predicted earlier, so that one is nice as it is on the new OnePlus series will likely not be happening. Another interesting tidbit is the power button now sits lower. The phone overall is growing in size, so it makes sense that Apple is positioning the button slightly lower than 11 Pro Max. This is a comfort move, I do like it. Gets even stranger, the SIM card tray, yeah, that's been relocated to the other side of the phone. Now unclear why this is happening. We can assume that the logic board is getting moved to the other side of the phone, and if you remember, compare Raja during the iPhone 11 Pro prototyping mentioned that Apple was looking into a new internal layout where the logic board sits up above the battery, and the battery being almost square-like shape will be taking up the bottom portion of the phone, so it would be less L-shaped like, more square-like. It's possible that that leak was just a year too early, and what's even crazier is what's replacing the SIM card tray is a smart connector. At first I was a little dubious of this, but seeing in the CAD actually printed, yes, it looks like a smaller version of the smart connector. It's just as wide, 3.5 millimeters, same width as the iPad Pro smart connector, and from that we can assume it is a smart connector, just a slightly not as long version. It's 21 millimeters, whereas the iPad one is 25 millimeters. Why would Apple add a smart connector to an iPhone? We don't know. We heard rumors long ago that Apple was working on an Apple Pencil for an iPhone, or Apple Pencil compatibility, of course. In its current state, it would not support an Apple Pencil, as the power button would intrude on that charging, but it's possible Apple could be working on a slew of other accessories and other uses for smart connector on the side of an iPhone. Interesting, in this CAD model has one less speaker hole on the right side speaker group versus the 11 Pro Max. Something back at the car I reported on the saying the speaker grille would be more uniform on the 2020 lineup. And speaking of speakers, back source reports that this year's iPhone will be getting better speakers, will be 10 to 15% louder with better dynamic range, something I'm very much looking forward to, as the speakers have not been getting louder lately. They've been getting deeper, better audio, but not louder. This is good news. And of course the Lightning port remains. Apple is not going to USB-C like we heard earlier. They're jumping straight to a portal's future, and asked why AirPower must come back in a question I have for the engineers out there. I personally think that this would make a difference, but a square design seems more logical for Apple going forward. It seems easier if Apple really is all about miniaturization, getting the most out of every nook and cranny inside the iPhone. A square design just seems logical, where they can cram more in into a thinner, smaller but wider and taller frame. And my impressions after handling this CAD model, while the bezels being shrunk goes a long way in making this thing feel much more futuristic, that in the thinner frame, I love that it's thinner. You know, we didn't have to be, but the fact that it's square design and it's thinner now it tricks your brain into feeling like this came from 10 years in the future. Couple other things for Max Windback. The navy blue color you're seeing a lot of our renters, it is happening. Apple is looking into it, directionally testing out two separate versions of it. Both are fairly dark, different shades of that navy blue. Apple is also considering replacing midnight green with a navy blue, which is most likely going to happen. Also, Apple is looking into new colors for the iPhone 12 successor non-pro model, and the colors they're looking into are a light blue shade of violet and a light orange. Out of those three colors Apple is considering keeping to, and it's unclear whether those will be replacing existing colors, I'd assume. So let me know what you think about design. Personally, I love it that Philip did iPad Pro design on an iPhone. Needed to happen long ago, but it's the perfect design to herald the new age of 5G in an iPhone. Also, we should know more with the next set of CADs. Remember, these are old from January 2020, so there will be more changes in the more finalized CADs. Will be sharing the future. And the last bit for Max Windback, that feature discovered and I was 14. Apparently Apple is trying to bring it all car manufacturers, or at least more. Right now they're working with BMW, which is why we saw the E8 and the I was 14 leak, and they're even working with Tesla. But Tesla is being prickly about the money law, and we want this feature on her iPhone's native integration. Would be sweet. When I was 13.4.5 beta 2 was dropped, one notable change is the new feature when sharing a song from Apple Music to Instagram stories now includes a direct link to visit that song. Apple Music. Apple is getting smarter, trying to get you to subscribe to Apple Music through features. Genius. Okay guys, this has got to be the craziest Apple leaks I've ever done. I've never shared a design on my channel that hasn't been seen elsewhere, but this is the iPhone 12 Pro. It's not only detailed, fully accurate, but this is the overall design. Let me know your comment below the section, and thanks for watching. See you on my next video.